a story about my old granddad. His quest for fame and glory and a dream he always had. To explore the ocean bed in a homemade submarine. So he built himself a diving bell from our old washing machine. He donned his diver's suit, climbed into our bell. At the bottom of our garden, we launched it in our well. Huddled up in his tiny craft, in short of elbow room, he submerged beneath the waves and vanished in the gloom. The Royal Navy tracked him near 3 months or more, but lost him in the Irish Sea, just 3 miles offshore. He was washed upon the beach, just like a stranded whale. His skin had turned all wrinkly, and his face a ghostly pale. Granddad's course was set for the bottom of the sea. So the children and mourners all sang along with me. Granddad, granddad, you silly old fool, you should have tried it out in the local swimming pool. Apparently his diving bell filled up like a bowl, and in the depths of his despair he must have lost control. His periscope must have jammed, the coroner did declare, but ruled his death was caused by the water in his air. Now my old Uncle Tommy is an undertaker of note. He could not find a floating hearse, so had to hire a boat. The mourners all wore snorkels as they bid him farewell, and we buried him at sea in his rusty diving bell. Now when I see a big squall or a massive tidal wave, I presume it's all the tears we shed on Granddad's grave. Or maybe it's the old man rolling on his side as he drifts across the reef with the changing of the tide. Granddad's course was set for the bottom of the sea. So the children and mourners all sang along with me. Granddad, granddad, you silly old fool, you should have tried it out in the local swimming pool. Now if you join the Navy, remember my old dad, the love he had for the sea, how it drove him mad. It's a maritime adventure that really is quite sad, and a warning to all old men and every sailing lad.